welcome to Messi's Fun and Matt's Lucky Show! Woo! Today now we are at the outdoors! Wow, so strong the winds! Okay. Today our lessons will be on Completing Square! How? Why we are standing here? We are actually coming to create a problem. Create a problem with what? With a stone. 1, 2, 3.
From our experiment just now, we noticed that the stones landed on the floor at the 3rd second. So we actually started by 0 and then it ended up 3 seconds. So from here, we know that our t is equal to 0 and also t equal to 3. Then we can actually build our own equations based on these two. That is t times with t minus 3 equal to 0. Hence, our functions will be, that is y equal to t, t minus 3. That is become t squared minus 3t. However, we know that our stone is actually forming the maximum point. These equations actually tell us that it's the minimum point. Therefore, we need to put the negative sign for all of them. Now, our function turns to be negative t squared plus 3t. So this is our equations. Now, it's the next step that we are going to use our completing square to find this value. That is the question mark. So we know y equal to negative t squared plus 3t. Then, we are going to put the completing square. Completing square, the first step must make sure your a value is 1. Here is a negative, so I need to factorize my negative out. So after done this one, completing square means that you need to plus and minus the value that is b over a. So you put t squared minus 3t, just follow. And then you plus with the value that is negative 3 over 2a squared. Then because you have put something that is plus, you also must put something that is minus, the same value. Next is this 3 is actually forming into their own completing square. That is t minus 3 over 2 squared. Yeah? Then this one is the last part, become negative 9 over 4. Don't you forget, you still have a negative outside. You need to multiply it inside. Then it becomes negative t minus 3 over 2 squared plus 9 over 4. So what is this y value telling you? Yeah. So here you have the 9 over 4. This is your maximum value. And this one, yeah. When you are going to achieve your maximum value, that is 9 over 4, t minus 3 over 2 is equal to 0. Then you know that it's a t 3 over 2. So if I'm going to put this value into the graph, you will notice that at t 3 over 2 seconds, the height here is actually 9 over 4 meter. Okay, so this is our maximum point. You put it into the coordinate 3 over 2, 9 over 4. Yeah. So our completing square already helped us in identifying how high the stone that I throw just now. Thank you for watching.